His day didn't start at dawn. It had years before, even generations before, when Jehovah had made the promise of a Messiah, and when the prophet had spoken.
He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. Like a lamb as it is led to be slaughtered, and like a sheep that cannot speak to his shearers, so he opened not his mouth.
Since the previous day, going through physical weariness and mental torment. As he talked to his friends and disciples, as he tried to make them understand, he thought of the coming ordeal. Some of even his closest friends thought that he would become a great king, and that they might become generals, or prime ministers, or people of great power. Possibly the one who kept the money for the group thought that he himself would become the minister of finance. When it was made clear that such earthly jobs weren't needed, the money keeper betrayed his friend.
And if one asks him, "What are these wounds on your back?" he will say, "The wounds I received in the house of my friends."
Night with heaven be
for 33 years. Now he would keep the promise his father had made for him to generation after generation of godly people.
Midnight and dawn.
Then Jesus went with them to a place called Gethsemane. And he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I go yonder and pray." And taking with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee, he began to be sorrowful and troubled. Then he said to them, "My soul is very sorrowful, even to death. Remain here and watch with me." And going a little farther, he fell on his face and prayed, "My Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as thou wilt."
They came and they took him.
Now Judas, who betrayed him, also knew the place, for Jesus often went there with his disciples. So Judas, procuring a band of soldiers and some officers from the chief priests and the Pharisees, went there with lanterns, torches, and weapons. Then Jesus, knowing all that was to befall him, came forward and said to them, "Who do you seek?" They answered him, "Jesus of Nazareth." Jesus said to them, "I am he." Jesus of Nazareth, I am he. I am he. I am he. The one that should kiss the man is the man. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Do you think that I cannot appeal to my Father and heal at once to me more than 12 legions of angels?
Came out to capture. What? An unarmed, itinerant preacher, a gentle teacher whose message was that all men are worthy of love and life. When the high priest questioned him about his disciples and his teaching, Jesus said,
"I've always spoken openly to the world. I've always taught in the synagogues and in the temple, where all Jews come together. I have never said anything secretly. Why do you ask me such questions? Ask those who heard me. Ask them what I say."
Thine ocean depths is flowing nature
for. Now some of the sorrows of the mind began. A trusted friend denied that he ever knew him.
Peter was sitting outside in the courtyard, and a young girl came up to him. She said, "You were with Jesus the Galilean." But Peter denied it before them all, saying, "I don't know what you mean." But when he went out to the porch, another maid saw him, and she said to some bystanders, "This man was with Jesus of Nazareth." And again he denied it with an oath, "I do not know the man." After a little while, the bystanders came up and said to Peter, "Of course you are also one of them. Your accent betrays you." Then he began to invoke a curse on himself and to swear, "I do not know the man." And immediately, the cock crowed.
By this time, the day was well advanced, but there was no sun to warm the people. The chill of death was hovering like a wet shroud on everyone. Now, in an attempt to give some slight legal tinge to all of these illegal actions, they took him to the governor.
Pilate entered the praetorium and called Jesus. "Are you the king of the Jews?" he asked. Jesus answered, "Do you say this on your own accord, or did someone tell you about me?" Pilate answered, "Do you think I am a Jew? Your own people and the chief priests have handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingship is not of this world. If my kingship were of this world, my servants would fight that I might not be handed over to the Jews. But my kingship is not from this world." Pilate said to him, "So you are a king?" Jesus answered, "You say that I am a king. I was born for this. And because of this, I have come into the world to be a witness of the truth. Everyone who is of the truth hears my voice." Pilate said to him, "What is truth?" Again and said to the people, "I am bringing him out to you so that you may know that I find no crime in him." Then Jesus came out, wearing the crown of thorns and a purple robe. Pilate said to them, "Here is the man." When the chief priests and the officers saw him, they cried out, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" Pilate said to them, "Take him yourselves and crucify him, for I find no crime in him." Pilate came into the praetorium again and asked Jesus where he was from. Still, Jesus gave no answer. Pilate said to him, "Why won't you speak to me? Don't you know that I have the power to release you and also the power to crucify you?" Jesus answered him, "You would have no power over me unless it had been given to you from above."
Suddenly, Pilate himself felt that death chill. He heard the Jews screaming, "If you release this man, you are not Caesar's friend." Of course he was Caesar's friend. Then he heard one voice screaming over the crowd, "Everyone who makes himself a king is an enemy of Caesar." That was the final insult. No small-time local preacher was going to jeopardize Pilate's political future with Rome. He shouted at the crowd, "Here is your king." They screamed, "Take him away. Away with him. Crucify him." Pilate said to them, "Do you want me to crucify your king?" The chief priest answered, "We have no king but Caesar."
Thank you.
A mob is a living organism, like a hawk or a lizard or a human being. It's born, it does its own work, and then it dies. This mob, this herd of rabble, had been created by the religious leaders, and now it was searching forward toward its own death. They took Jesus to the place called the place of the skull. In the Hebrew, the word was Golgotha. It was a traditional place for such executions, and the mob knew the road. That's where they crucified him, and along with him were two thieves, one crucified on his left and one on his right.
Every time I think about Jesus, every time I think about Jesus, every time I think about Jesus, knowing he died on Calvary tree.
He listened to them mock him. One of the mob walked up and snarled, "So you're the one who would destroy the temple and rebuild it in 3 days. Why don't you save yourself?" Another yelled, "If you're the Son of God, come down off that cross." Even the chief priests and the scribes and the elders got caught up in the mob's frenzy. They mocked him and said, "He saved others, but he cannot save himself. He calls himself the King of Israel. If he comes down from that cross, we'll believe him." Even one of the robbers screamed, "Aren't you the Messiah? Then please, save us all." This was his moment. This was the culmination of his life on earth. It was for this moment that he had entered the taunts and privations of his life. It was for this instant that he had come from his Father to live among men.
Jesus cried with a loud voice and yielded up his spirit. And behold, the curtain of the temple was torn in two, from the top to the bottom. And the earth shook and the rocks were split. The tombs were opened and the bodies of the saints who had fallen asleep were raised. When the centurion and those who were with him saw the earthquake and what had taken place, they were filled with awe and said, "Truly, this man was the Son of God." Day of preparation for the Passover, a holy day to the Jews. To prevent the bodies from remaining on the cross over the high holy day of Passover,
The Jews came to Pilate and asked that the soldiers break the legs of Jesus and the two robbers to hasten their death.
Jesus and saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. But one of the soldiers pierced his side with the spear, and at once there came out blood and water. Joseph, from Arimathea, who was a disciple of Jesus, asked Pilate if he might take away the body of Jesus, and Pilate gave him permission. Nicodemus, also who had first come to him by night, came bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes. They took the body of Jesus and bound it in a linen cloth with the spices, as is the burial custom of the Jews. In the place where he was crucified, there was a garden, and in the garden, a new tomb where no one had ever been laid. So because it was the Jewish day of preparation, and the tomb was close by, they laid Jesus there.
It was finished. He had performed his mission completely, and now he was free of the terror that had followed him like a shadow. As the prophets had said, he was despised and he was rejected by his own people. But now he was about to be heard by the entire world. His name would be trumpeted throughout the ages, this man who died in poverty. His would be the name above all names. He was the Messiah sent from the Creator of the world. This Jesus, who had lived among men, was the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
From him with many crowns, the Lamb upon his throne, art thou the heavenly anthem, crown the perfect body soul. Awake my soul and sing of him who died for thee, and hail him as thy matchless king throughout eternity. Crown him the Lord of heaven, and with the Father glory, and let the Spirit to his gift from yonder glorious throne. All hail, Redeemer,
Christ child, they have resentment and do follow. Now is born the divine Christ child,
that we can rejoice this day.
Ages long since the first dawn gone, when the wise men foretold his coming. Ages long since the first dawn gone, the world no longer let us see.
Now with voice that is mine, Christ's child, may the music, may the tune follow. Now with voice that is mine, Christ's child, let us sing and rejoice this day. He was born in a stable there,
and then a star, now he sleeps so soundly.
He was born in a stable there,
bowing homage to him now.
Now with voice that is mine, Christ's child, play the music, play the tune, follow the bold. Now with voice that is mine, Christ's child, let us sing and rejoice this day. Our Father who is in heaven, God, how hallowed be thy name.
Kingdom come, thy kingdom come, thy will be done throughout this earth.
Our Father who is in heaven, God, how hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done throughout this earth, we pray.
Kingdom come, thy kingdom come, thy will be done throughout this earth, we pray.
Our Father who is in heaven, God, how hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done throughout this earth, we pray.
Thank you. You see. be a place for you.
Give away, give away all. Amen. garden,
hey,
talking to his
father, hey,
to take this sorrow,
amen, 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 amen.
Led before Pilate,
amen,
then he crucified him,
amen,
so triumphant,
amen, amen, amen,
hallelujah,
amen,
he died to save us,
amen,
forever,
amen, amen,
thank you. Tomorrow a common joy in the truth of God.